My name is Atul Madhusudan. I'm currently working in the Cohen-Karni Lab at Carnegie Mellon University. I'm a first-year master's student at the Department of Biomedical Engineering. So I primarily work on graphene-based sensor platforms for measuring electrical activity in the brain. Our main goal here is to learn about how cells communicate with each other, how the electrical transduction between the cells move around in the brain. It kind of helps us understand how the brain actually works. This could help us understand the reason behind different neurological disorders, Alzheimer's or Parkinson's to name a few, which are based on the electrical transduction of the signals in the brain. I am from Bangalore in India. From my early schooling days, I have always had like a liking for biology. I don't know if it was because of the drawing the diagrams or learning about different stuff of the body. So initially I wanted to be a doctor, but somewhere down the line I was interested in the applications of engineering into the sciences. I've always wanted to get into medical research mainly because I've always seen this problem, maybe not personally, but a problem of where doctors are not able to diagnose diseases quite early and quite significantly. I mean, you kind of detect cancer in stage 5 or stage 4 and not very early. And so I was thinking, I mean, why are we missing this tool or some technique which can, you know, help doctors try to identify the disease quite early on and quite rapidly, I guess. The research that we do in our lab is a very interdisciplinary research. This kind of opens up a lot of avenues to collaborate with different researchers, some professionals who are really good at electrical engineering or really good at material science. So this opens up a lot of different ways in which you can interact with them, learn more about it. So this kind of gives you a very holistic approach of going into medical research. It definitely helps you understand not just one particular area of expertise, but multiple areas of expertise. Understanding these electrical signals or electrical activities will help us understand why certain neurological disorders are caused. I mean, why Alzheimer's occurs or why Parkinson's occurs. And once we understand why this occurs, it could lead to possible cures or treatment of these diseases and also early diagnostics of these diseases. So in the bigger picture, I think it's our research. I'm really hopeful that we're able to contribute to this field.